Hi friends, this is Hari Naganand Idmudi. If you want to get more updates, please subscribe our channel. If you want to join in my WhatsApp group, please send a message to 970-445-5002. Dear students, get ready for the passage relating to shorthand, that is 95 words per minute.
Start. All this has usually a decisive impact at the higher levels of decision making and administration in the universities. For both the representatives of college managements and of teachers secure representation in the various bodies of the universities of which they form a part. Changes in the structure and content of courses are therefore usually resisted if they call for more appointments at the college level than the managements are prepared to make, or if much more effort is required on the part of the existing staff. If any teaching is organized at the university level, as is generally done for postgraduate courses, the principle of representation has to be usually given considerable weight irrespective of academic considerations. The various sectional interests involved have to be taken into account also when examiners are appointed by universities, and sometimes even when the results of the examinations are declared. Para. Universities as organized now are in fact highly vulnerable to pressures of various kinds. The representation given to colleges, the system of elections to the more important decision-making bodies, and direct dependence on government grants are all potential instruments for gaining influence and exerting pressure within universities. It is not surprising, therefore, that when teachers and students are also free to participate in political activity, universities get affected very quickly by all the undercurrents and conflicts in the society of which they are a part. One of the major problems now is that while political forces are able to gain entry very easily, the universities do not have the means for effectively coping with them. Para. Under these conditions, growth in size beyond a point becomes a particularly serious handicap. Not only are there few economies of scale to be gained by such expansion, but diseconomies set in through their great vulnerability to pressures from outside and from within. This has become a major problem for many Indian universities. The growing tendencies towards regionalism in the country have also had serious effects on higher education. These tendencies are generally expressed in demands relating to the medium of instruction. Some of these demands are based on sound educational principles and are wholly justifiable, but in their most extreme form, they usually indicate either ignorance of the minimum requirements of higher education or inward-looking conduct of a kind that places considerations of a selfish character above these requirements. In practice, both have been in evidence. More specifically, the problem arises when instruction at the postgraduate level is sought to be given in the regional languages. For most of the relevant literature at that level is usually not available. Stop.